Hey guys, so in this tutorial we are going to learn about execute stream command, and this processor is used to run your own script. So let's say you have a script which is created in Java or Python or any other language, and in this session you are going to learn how you can utilize that script in order to perform some operation on the flow file. So whenever you have a scenario in which you are not able to implement that using NiFi processors and you want to create your own custom script, you can always use execute stream command processor. So now let me tell you what is the problem statement I have. So let's say I have a data like employee name, and also I have a data like monthly salary. And let's say name of each employee is given in this format. And monthly salary is appended in a single cell using pipe delimiter. Okay, and in this case, let's say you want to perform some transformation and you want to see the data like so let's say before performing any transformation your data was like this, and after the transformation you want your data to be splitted like this. This functionality is commonly known as explode in Python, and also it is commonly known as normalization. So this kind of functionality can be implemented by writing your own custom scripts. So in my problem statement, what I'm going to do is I'm going to run this get file, and I'm going to show you the file which I receive. So if you see, the file which I receive is having a column which is called flag, and in the flag column I have multiple flags, and this is separated by a pipe. Let's say I want to perform a normalization or explode operation on this. So for that one I have written a custom script, and I'm going to call that script using execute script command. So now the way to use execute script command is very simple. You can go into the processor and type execute script command, and then you can add this processor here. So since I have already added this processor, I'm just going to delete this one and going to show you the configuration which I have done. So if we right click on execute stream command and click on configure, then you will see we have something called command path. In the command path you need to provide the script name which you have developed, and in the command arguments you are going to type the name of the arguments which you are going to pass. So in my script I have created the script in such a way that it is going to receive one argument, and that argument is going to be a column name. As I shown you, in my scenario I have a column name which is called flag, and I want to explode this into multiple rows. So that's why I'm passing one argument which is called flag, which is a column name. And in the argument delimiter, if you have multiple arguments, you can use argument delimiter. And in that case you can pass multiple arguments using a delimiter. Let's say I can pass multiple arguments using something like this. So this is going to base depending on your use case. In my use case I do not have any additional column. I have just created it to accept only one argument. So I'm just going to pass only one argument. And that is the only change which I have made here. I have not made any other change here. I will also show you what is the script which I have written in this Python normalize.py Python program. So if you see, my script is very straightforward. using Python 3 in order to write this script. So whatever flow file which is received from get file is going to be passed to execute stream command as a standard input. So you need to accept, your program should be able to accept the standard input, and then it should be able to perform operation on that standard input. So if you see, I have written this piece of code which is called sysstdin. So what it does is, whatever data which is sent from previous flow file, this piece of line is going to receive the data, and then it is going to send all the data to a file object which is a pandas object. So I'm not going to explain this program to you. The only thing which you need to know is that in order to handle a standard input, you need to write a code which can handle standard input. And standard input is going to receive all the contents which was provided by the previous processor. So all the data which you see here in the success queue, it is going to go to execute stream command. And in the execute stream command, it is going to be handled by standard input. And after that, you are going to write the logic to perform operation on that data. In my case, I'm splitting the data and then I'm performing explode function. And after that is done, you can write the output back to standard output. So in that case, the next processor in which is connected to execute stream command is going to receive that output. So let me run this and see how it works. So we have already started get file and we have received 5 flow files. So let's see the content of the flow files. So if you see the content of the flow files, in the flag column we have multiple attributes separated by pipe delimiter. So now I'm going to run execute stream command. And I have connected execute stream command with a funnel. This funnel is just going to act like a placeholder in this situation. And I have joined this funnel with original non-zero and output stream relationship. If you right click on execute stream command relationship, you will notice that we have 3 relationships. One is non-zero status and the other one is original and the output stream. So all these relationships data are going to be submitted to the next processor. So when I start execute stream command, you'll be noticing that 3 file has been passed to original. So this original relationship is going to have the content of original file. So if you see in the original queue, we are not having any change in the data. It is having exactly the same data which was passed in the original flow file. So I'm going to go back and going to see output stream. In the output stream, right click and select list queue and then open a flow file. Now you'll be noticing the flag column has been separated by pipe delimiter. So now we see more number of rows, and each number of rows are having only one value against flag, and the data has been splitted. So this is something which we wanted to see in this problem statement. If you have any other problem statement, you can write your own custom script and you can call that custom script using execute stream command.